Hey, what's up, Unc? How you doing?
Hey, Sonny, now is that PYT you listening to over there now?
Yeah, how'd you know? This your song?
Now, let me show you how we used to do it back in my day.
Let me see you bust a move to it.
Oh, son, let me tell you right now, I'm
perfectly fine.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. I gotta come with a jacket today. Glasses, jacket, shirt. Call me Glasses, Jacket, Shirt Man. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Bruce Rants. That's Bruce Rants episode Dick. Dick is Esperanto for 10. Esperanto was a language created in 1887 and means one who hopes in English. I'm one who hopes this video is at least relatively funny to you, or even slightly entertaining. No, but seriously, hope is a powerful thing, and every time I make one of these videos, I sincerely hope that it brightens your day in one way or the other, whether you laugh, whether you cry, whether you look at me and use me as the scapegoat for all of the stupidity that you've ever experienced in your life and say, this guy is probably the dumbest, most silly, obnoxious person I've ever met on the internet. I want to be that person for you, so enjoy the rest of the video. Intro done. Esperanto is you. You are Esperanto. So one thing all of you should know about me is that I went to the illustrious North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University. This being an HBCU, a historically black college or university, dancing has a big prevalence within black culture and therefore had a very big prevalence on the HBCU campus. One of the things I gathered specifically from this HBCU was that black people specifically like dance circles. Black people will hype any dance circle. You could be making French toast and black people will go, mix the eggs, drop the toast, My favorite part about the dance circle is always the white dude who jumps in out of nowhere, because he's either coming with step of five choreography or he's about to hit the whatchamacallit. Either way, it's offbeat and everybody cheers louder than they cheered for anyone else. Every dance circle always has a girl twerking too, which I never understood, because it's always like two twerks and then a laugh and a runaway. Why are you laughing and running away? Jesus already done seen what you did. It's always literally and figuratively a blessing when the crumpers show up to the dance circle. Believe it or not, crumping is a Christian dance. Backstory, crump stands for kingdomly, radically uplifted, mighty praise, derived from clowning. Which makes sense, because I've seen Pennywise fidget like that too. Now, all I want to know is what in the get this spider the hell off of me dance moves was going on in church that made people do that? Jesus up there looking at crumpers like Kawhi Leonard. Hey. I see why crumping never really got heavily tied to church though. It's probably really hard to give tithe while, you know, doing this. I know that wasn't the best crumping you've ever seen. It's probably like top three, not three. I personally always love a good pop and lock. All the best dancers do it. Chris Brown, Michael Jackson, Usher. You can do almost anything in a pop and lock and it looks lit. I love how dance is so closely tied to culture. It seems like white people and Indian people have the same ear when it comes to dancing, i.e. they can't hear the beat at all. But you know, I like their dances way more, way easier than what the black people are doing. Remember when white people had dances like the twist?
you just stepped on a roach and then like ruined your shoe with it a little bit. Or that swim thing, you know, like the fake drowning. Like, black people were doing it too. I was doing it, except I was doing it in a pool. And I couldn't swim, so it was real.
Or the sprinkler, you know, like, they been wanted to slap their kids. This is just cathartic release for them. Cathartic release.
And Indian people, just keep screwing in that imaginary light bulb. Fun tangential but related fact for those of you who do not know, the Caucasus Mountains are home to Mount LeBron. Elbrus, the highest mountain in Europe. Now you know damn well Caucasian people went up there to go spy on these damn dance moves. How are these guys doing this? It's like they just know what the beat's gonna do next. It's either that or Chief Okunga banished them and said, "Hey, my friend, go up there and don't come back until you learn how to two-step, eh?" It took me a while to realize that the club is not a place you dance. It's really just a place for ugly people to drink and hide in plain sight until the lights come on at 3 a.m. Now, I'm a dancing dude, so when I hit the club, I just go in and hit everything. I hit the bar, I hit the dance floor, I hit the nay-nay, and then I hit the bathroom because I hit the bar, and my bladder did the nay-nay. It didn't take me long to realize that was wrong until I looked around and saw it was 90% women going, "Uh-uh, I'm dancing with my friends." And then 10% of men watching the woman who denied them dance with their friends. I always wanted club scenes to be like the movies, you know, like how there's like a dance battle in the movie or whatever. The closest thing we get is when everyone does the Cupid shuffle and he says, to the left, and half the people accidentally go right. And what is with these group dances? How do all of you know this choreography? Club Choreo 101 was not on the registration list. Personally, I've never caught a twerk from a random woman at the club. I don't have good fishing lures, like lots of money or self-confidence. Ooh. I got the crappy lures. Like, I can program in 3 different languages. Or I can sing Irreplaceable by heart. Came to the point where I just thought about sneaking up on women at the spot, you know? Jumping on that booty before she heard me say, "To the left, to the left." I gave up on that quick though. I'm dark, it's dark, you can't hear me. I'm sneaking up on random women all night. I felt like Ghostface from Scream. Long story short, club dancing wasn't really for me. I'm more of like a professional dancing kind of guy, you know? I like how dance instructors have the weirdest names for dance moves. I understand though why you would name dance moves weird, because how else could you remember it? I mean, just like left, 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 right, right, step, step, walk sounds like a GTA cheat code. I put in that long string of buttons and I still don't know how to do the Cupid shuffle. If I'm a dance instructor, I'm naming my dance moves after food groups. Meatball, meatball, meatball. Asparagus saucy. I could be out here the Gordon Ramsay of a shuffle ball change. My dance instructions will be so vividly attuned to food that I'll teach you how to make chicken parm and do a backspin. You're like 2 steps from being the perfect date. Or getting denied at the club. Either way, you can make chicken parm. Who hates chicken parm? I hate chicken parm, but I'm weird. I'm not the standard. I love those dance songs that tell you exactly what to do in the song, like the Soulja Boy. I feel like you could tell anybody anything in a song, and they probably do exactly what you say.
This beat is fire. Wait, I'm going to show you guys how to do a dance. The dance is called hitting that Bruce, okay? Pay attention very closely to the words. This will teach you exactly how to do it. I promise. Just wait for the beat to drop. Where's the beat? Huh? Yay, I got swag. Get my hands on some money. I'ma put it in the bag, babe. Bands on the road, but that joint go fast, and I'ma put it in gear, and I'ma dip on that ass.
Dip.
Listen what I say. Punch her in the face. Don't got your faith. Go slap a hoe and then patch your wave and nug if you buck like it's 2008.
Ooh, aggressive.
After that, you did a bit. Do a little jig. Don't fix your fit. Let me see you, Mike Jack. Gonna do a little kick, and you dancing like that. Gonna touch a little kid. Licky, let me see you blicky dance. Keep that boy on sight. Throw it up, watch that joint fall from the sky. Put your hand up, damn bro, threw it too high.
Catch it, whoa.
Take a peek, now you got some in your eye. Take a seat down, cause you gotta be tied. Lay down on the floor, boy, act like you died. I said, act like you died. I said, die, stupid, die.
Hey, take your wallet out and put it to the side.
Hey, you in the background, pick up that wallet. It's your wallet now.
Now your wallet's gone. Now your wallet's gone. That's my wallet. Say that's my wallet. Hey, that's my wallet. Hey, say that's my wallet. Hey, that's my wallet. Hey, don't touch that wallet. Hey, that's his wallet. Hey, now your wallet's gone. Now your wallet's gone. Can I have my wallet back? No. 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 Does this wallet have cash? No. Can I have my wallet back? No. Can I have my wallet back? No. Can I have my wallet back? No. Hey, for real, go get your wallet though, cause you probably need that to pay bills. Like, I apologize for that. Actually, he's gone now. I don't know where he went, but he's probably using every card you have to buy every Oreo McFlurry there is at McDonald's. He got your wallet, hey.